Hello everyone. In this video, we will see how we can use Anuta Atom to create low-code workflows to automate your networks. Workflow automation handles use cases that are more task-oriented and where no lifecycle has to be maintained. It could be activities such as software upgrades or any method of procedure-driven provisioning or troubleshooting activities. This slide gives us a high-level idea on how a workflow with an Atom looks like. The workflow can be triggered by an external tool such as ServiceNow or from Atom. Then there could be a number of pre-checks that will be done before performing an activity. You can think of these pre-checks as show commands to make sure that the device satisfies all the prerequisites. You may have to obtain an approval before performing an activity. This could be about raising a ticket on ServiceNow, and once approved, device upgrade or provisioning activity will be carried out. Then comes a post-check, where the same set of pre-checks can be run again and can be compared in a decision box to make sure that the activity was successful. Atom's workflow engine is based on a standard called BPMN 2.0. Let us look at some examples to understand this better. This is a provisioning workflow that helps organizations to migrate their IP stack from IPv4 to IPv6. There could be several variables such as multiple vendors, multiple regions, and multiple validations as part of this migration. To begin with, Atom offers a user form where all the user inputs such as device list are taken. Then based on the device list, reachability is checked through ping to ensure that the devices are online. Once we find that the device is online, the latest configurations are pulled, after which the inventory database is checked to ascertain the vendor, as the prechecks for each vendor is going to be different. The precheck here is represented as a thicker box, which means it's a different workflow that is being called into the main workflow as a sub-process. You can think of this as a reusable library that is present within Atom. This is the pre-check workflow that shows multiple vendor validations being captured. You can see show commands for each vendor and various platforms involved. The error scenarios for every task is notified back to the main workflow to take an action based on the logic involved. If the pre-checks are successful, then the workflow proceeds to the next step. It'll perform interface-specific configurations and routing-specific configurations based on the inputs. After the provisioning, the configurations are pulled again to ensure consistency on both sides. The post-checks are the same pre-check steps are executed again, and the validation is done in the same workflow as a sub-process seen here. If the validation fails due to some mismatch, the rollback commands, including the releasing of IPAM given IPs, rollback commands for interface and routing configurations, are performed to ensure that the network state is back to what it was. If the activity was successful, but you plan to roll back after a few days of verification, the rollback commands are ready to go after the approval. Here is another example where a workflow is used to upgrade a device. The workflow takes inputs such as device IP, software image details, and FTP server details to kick off the workflow. The workflow executes few show commands initially and then performs a disk space check that is called from the reusable library of tasks that are available on Atom. Once enough disk space is confirmed, few more prerequisite checks such as file system checks, some of the key show command snapshots that we care about is taken. The image server is contacted and the image is uploaded to the device. If any step in the workflow is time-taking, the same can be verified for completion by going over the task iteratively over a period of time. The image is then activated and we are ready to reboot the device. An approval is triggered to ServiceNow or any ITSM tool with all the necessary information for the admin to analyze, and once the approval comes back, the workflow reboots the device. A configurable timer is activated, and the workflow waits for a reboot trap notification, making this a bidirectional workflow. This means the workflow not only communicates, provisions, and upgrades the device, but also listens to the network events to take an action or even trigger a workflow. The post checks are performed, and if validations pose concerns, the workflow can roll back to ensure that the device is on the previous best known image. Multiple such workflows can be run simultaneously to handle any complex scenarios. In case of a software upgrade, this workflow here was for Cisco IOS XR device. However, Atom supports multi-vendor upgrade procedures. And here is the Juniper MX upgrade workflow that works on the similar principles. It is a multi-level in-service upgrade that has Junos upgrade, selective upgrade, and CLI package upgrade as part of the workflow. As seen here, this main workflow has several sub-workflows. It includes disk space checks, pre-checks in the form of show commands, some of the prerequisites done as part of the Juniper upgrade procedure, different upgrade procedures involved, and finally the post-checks for the validation of the upgrade. Here is a pre and post check workflow that has around 49 commands as part of the method of procedure. The workflow also takes care of error scenarios, where any error at any of these tasks will also lead to a rollback procedure within the same workflow. With all the annotations, Atom's workflow engine can also act as a documentation that will help network teams to get rid of maintaining separate documentation. We can also track the progress of each workflow. The yellow legend here shows the present stage of the workflow, and this legend will move across as the workflow progresses. We can also see the number of workflows and what stage each of them are. For example, here you can see that there are 16 active workflows waiting for an approval. The workflows can also be suspended or resumed for any validation, and also retried in case of any errors. So how are these workflows created? A workflow builder that is based on BPMN 2.0 is packaged into Atom. This is the workflow builder, and you can drag and drop these boxes and convert them into tasks. It could be a user task or a system task or even a script task where one can integrate existing Python or similar scripts into the workflow. Behind each of these tasks involve minimum scripting in Python, Groovy, or JavaScript that will form the payload for some of the Atom APIs to automate your method of procedures. There are many tasks where no coding is required, such as creating a user form. So while you can utilize out-of-the-box workflows in Atom, you can also create workflows within Atom and start using them. To offer additional value, Atom offers a catalog of items to create a workflow. It offers different APIs, including Atom-specific APIs, alerts, existing workflows, service models, compliance policies, etc., that customers can use to create the workflow. The API and the corresponding payloads are predefined so that it makes it much easier for the developers. This can be seen in the input parameters of the API that we just dragged and dropped. The only thing that we have to do is to write a simple script to do some post-processing of the output from the device. This will be part of the output parameters of the pane. As seen in this example, we are doing a show version on a Juniper device. The output is being compared against a parameter fed as a user input, and that output is stored into a variable. This variable can be used anywhere in the workflow. For example, in this workflow, we are using it as part of the decision box to determine the path we need to take for the workflow. Every step of the workflow is documented in detail, and one can verify each step of the workflow and even perform a diff between tasks for verification. In this completed workflow, you can see the different API used, the variables involved, the pre-checks and the post-checks performed. You can also do a diff between pre-checks and post-checks and perform validations. You can also verify the steps in the workflow in the tasks pane. For example, here we are looking at the generated commands for a particular automation scenario. To summarize, Atom has several out-of-the-box workflows. While they can be readily consumed, you can modify them using Atom's inbuilt workflow designer or create new ones to automate your method of procedures. Thanks for watching.